Hi, hello and welcome to Techguru.civil. In this STAAD.Pro e-learning series, today we are going to discuss about 2D analysis of continuous beam problem. Problem number 1. Here our given task is to analyze the continuous beam and to determine the support reactions, do the equilibrium check for the results we got. Then we need to draw SFD, BMD and elastic curve. Here make a note that here the AND calculation results are provided. We need to cross verify the same with the software analysis results. Now let's move on to the STAAD.Pro. Now let's get started with the STAAD.Pro Connect edition. If you are using the software for the first time, it is better advisable to do the configurations before starting any problem. Now click on the configuration option provided, go to the general, then select the base unit as metric, then go to design codes. For the steel, select IS800 from the drop down. For concrete, select IS456 from the drop down. Now click on the section database and select Indian as the default country code. Then click on save, then click OK. Once it is done, we are ready to go and click on the new project to create a file. Now provide the model information. File name, I will give it as problem 1. Then select the location, click on the browse button and select the particular folder. Type up the model, let it be analytical, unit system, metric. Next, job info, provide the job name. I will say it as continuous beam problem 1. It's a continuous beam 1. Then client, I'm going to provide it as Department of Civil Engineering. Then job number 01, revision 00. It's a part of structural analysis. Then reference. It is we are going to solve the problems from the assignment problems. Then engineer name, provide your name. I'm going to take it as XYZ. Then provide the date of the submission. Then checked by, you can provide your team manager or the lecture name. Then cross verification date. Then it is approved by. You can provide co-faculty name or the HOD name. I'm going to provide it as another professor name. Then provide the date. If you have any comments regarding this particular problem, you can provide it here. Now leave the connect information, click on create. Before going on to the problem, we need to cross verify two things. One is the UCS, another one is the unit. Here, if you observe the UCS, we can find that it is in isometric view. So we need front view. Go to the view tab, click on the front view option. Now go back to the geometry. Now go to the unit option available here. Go to metric. Here I need meter and kilonewton. Select it and click on apply. Now in order to create the geometry, go to the coordinate option and provide, start with 0. Now the origin has been created, A point. Then B point is at a distance of 4 meter. Then C point is at a distance of 9 meter from A. Then D point is at a distance of 15 meter from point A. Once it is done, click on this graphical window, click on add beam. Now click from one node to the another node. Once the geometry has been ready, move on to the properties panel. Here the property is empty, click on define. I'm going to provide rectangular property for the beam. Let the width will be 0.23 meter and YD depth will be 0.3 meter. Material, let it be concrete. Click add. Close. Now select that property. I need to assign this property to the entire beam. Now select the Assign to View option, click on Assign, click Yes. Now go to the material, it has been already added and assigned. Specification, we don't need it here. Then move on to the support. As per the given problem, we need to provide fixed support, simple and roller. Simple and roller have only one reaction, that is acting vertical. So click on create, select fixed, click add, next create. In order to create simple support or roller support, we will move on to the fixed butt option. We know that simple or roller having only one reaction, that acts vertical. So vertical means FY, it is the reaction, but here we need releases. So except FY, select all other things, click add. Now we need to assign the support. In order to assign the supports, we need to know node numbers or the node points should be highlighted. To make it so, on your keyboard, press Shift K so that the nodes get highlighted. Now select the support, fixed support, select Use Cursor to Assign option, click on Assign and click at A point and D point. Now select Simple Support, next click on B point and C point. Now move on to the loading, select Load Case Details, click Add. Now let the load case will be live load, since we are doing only the 2D analysis. Now click add, close, select that live load case, click add. Since it is a beam problem, all the load is going to act on the members. So move on to the member load. On the AB span, we have concentrated force of minus 50. It will be acting at a distance of 2 meter in the global y direction. Click add. The load has been added under the live load case. Now on the BC span, we need uniform load. Click on uniform force and the load will be minus 15. The minus sign indicates the downward direction. Next, if the UDL or UEL acting over the entire length of that particular member, then no need to provide the distances, leave it. Select global y direction, click add. Next we need concentrated force of minus 80. It will be acting at a distance of 2 meter, the global y direction, click add, close. Now select the concentrated load, use cursor to assign, assign, click on the first member, uniform force, click on the second member, concentrated force, click on the third member. Once it is ready, go to the analysis, click on the analysis command, perform analysis, click on no print, add, close. Now go to the post analysis command, on the left hand side, define commands, select analysis results, add, close. Now go to the run analysis option, click it and save it. In this output window, here you can observe we got 0 error, 0 warning and 0 note. Here we have 3 options. One is to view the output file, or to go to the post processing mode, or to stay back in the modeling mode. I will click on view output file, click done. I will maximize the window. Here you can observe, here you are going to get the STAAD.Pro name along with the version, then the manufacturer of this STAAD.Pro, Bentley, then today's date and time. Then here it is the input details we have given to this problem. Then we have problem statistics. Then we have the analysis results like joint displacement, support reactions and member end forces. We have already discussed that these analysis results should be cross verified with the and calculated results. Cross verify as well as do the equilibrium check. We know that the equilibrium check is, if it is a intermediate joint support, then sum of the moment should be 0. If it is a lost joint, then if it is provided with simple roller or hinge, then the moment at that point will be 0. If it satisfies, then close this window. On the left side in the workflow page control, go to the post processing mode, select the load case, click OK, maximize the window. Now turn off this displacement option. Now we are going to analyze the results in the post processing mode, as well as we need to create the report as per the report format provided. So what I'm going to do now first means I will this workflow page is pinned. I will undo this one, then it will be collapsed on the left hand side. Now I will maximize the window, turn up the results, click on the view load diagram. In order to bring it to the proper scale, now click on the scale option. We know that scale and drawing are inversely proportional. If we increase the scale, the drawing will get decreased. Now click on apply immediately and go on increasing the point force scale. You can see the results instantaneously in the graphical window. Now I need to increase this distance force. So click on increase. Now once it is ready, click apply, click OK. Or once it is ready, click on the labels, click on load values under the load display options. Now click apply and click OK. Once we got the diagram, take the picture. For taking the picture, right click and click on take picture. The picture one, I'm going to give it as wall structure, WS. In the caption, I'm going to write it as load diagram. Click OK. Next, we need support reactions. Click on the support reactions, maximize the window. Now go to the annotate options, go to the reaction tab. Since it is 2D analysis, I need only global X, global Y and global RZ reactions. Now untick all other options, rest of the options. Now if you want to see the results graphically, click on the show lines and provide some values. I'm going to scale it as 50-50. You can adjust it later. Click on annotate. Now close. We got our diagram. In order to take the picture, with the proper color scheme, click on the structure, click on loads and results. Here in the case of the loads, the moment is provided with the green yellow color. I will change that one. I will change it to red, then click on OK. Click OK. Once it is ready, right click, click on take picture, and ID I am going to provide it as SR. Caption, let it be support reaction. Click OK. Then we will move on to the beam results. Maximize the window. First, turn off this one. I need shear force diagram. Click on FY. Now by holding the control, move your mouse wheel towards front or back in order to make the drawing larger or smaller. It is the shortcut for scaling. Now in order to see the results, click on annotate, go to the beam results and select shear, as well as for bending, as well as for displacement. Click on annotate, click OK, close it. Once you get the value, right click, click on take picture. It is SFD. Caption, it is shear force diagram. Then click OK. Now turn off that one by clicking on the same option. Now MZ is the bending moment diagram. Click on that one. Now by using control and your mouse wheel, increase it. Once it is proper, right click and select take picture. ID I'm going to give it as BMD. Caption, let it be bending moment diagram. Now click OK. Now turn off that diagram. Now I need, since it is a beam problem, I need displacement. Click on the displacement. Hold the control button on your keyboard and move your mouse wheel in the forward direction. You will get the displacement results in terms of mm. Now right click, click on take picture. I'm going to write it as displacement. Let the ID be this, then the caption displacement, or in the bracket I'm going to provide it as elastic curve. Close the bracket, click OK. Now once it is ready, we will move on to the report section. Here we have various options like items, load cases, mode, range, steel design, picture album. In the picture album, whatever the pictures you have took, it will appear here. You can make it full page, or you can delete the picture, or you can do the dimension adjustment here. Then load or save, name and logo options. Now I will move on to the items. From the input, the job info has already been taken, so let it be. Next, go to the output and search for the reaction. Reactions. Now click on the forward single arrow button. Next, search for the beam end forces. For the final moments, click on the forward button. Now go to the picture album, select all the pictures and move it. In order to move all the pictures, click on the double forward arrow button. Now as per the report format, first we need job info, next we need the whole structure. Select that whole structure. Here we have two options in order to arrange these things in a proper manner. Now click on the upward arrow button. Job info, all structures, then we need reactions, then we need support reaction diagram. Click on the support reaction diagram, click on upward button, then beam end forces, then we need SFD, BMD and displacement. Okay, it is ready now. Now here we need to go for options. Now untick this footer and header options. Let the page outline will be there. Then go to the name and logo. Then click on load or save. We will come back to this one later. Now just click OK. Once it is ready, we can see the report here. Now click on setup report. Go to the load or save button. Click on save as. I'm going to write it as problem 1, let it be P1, click OK. Now click OK. I can click on setup print, or I will go back to the file option. I will click on print. Here we have four options. We can print input command file, then output file, report and error report. Input command file is nothing but STAAD editor file. You can print that one. Now click on that one. It will be like this. If you want to do any settings, you can do that one. Now click on print. Select your online PDF creators. Next, if you want to change any preferences, you can change it from here. click OK, then click Apply, then click Print. Printing completed, click OK. Now again go back to the file menu, click on Print. Now if we want to print our report, click on that one, then click on Print, then select your printer, then select click OK. It will ask you where to save the file. Select your folder, then click Save. Your output file will be like this. It consisting of job information, then structure type, then input details, then it is the load diagram, then we have reactions, then support reactions, beam end forces, then shear force diagram, bending moment diagram, and displacement or elastic curve. Thanks for watching the video.